Off-road riding is one area that I'm very unfamiliar with and I'm always very nervous about it. What I think, how I ride in off-road. How I actually ride in off-road. After riding a big adventure bike like Africa Twin and my 125cc scrambler experience in Lombok, I always wonder how does it feel to be riding a small to mid-size adventure bike that is below 180kg. So in today's video, I'm going to experience the CFMoto 450MT at their global launch event in El Nido, Philippines. I want to challenge and embrace myself in my most unfamiliar terrain. I'll be riding in one of the best off-road routes on this island. So thank you, CFMoto Singapore, for inviting us for this event. We flew at dawn and landed at Leo Airport Terminal, which was about 1 hour plus away from Manila. Arriving at Sedar Leo, we were greeted by a huge CFMoto banner with the bikes displayed. The anticipation soared for the adventures that awaited. We were welcomed with refreshments as we collected our media kits. That's where the launch event is going to be. After some rest, I'm going to head over to the venue where the launch event party is going to be. To be honest, the bike is actually quite nice. So excited, can't wait for tomorrow. At the CFMoto global launch, their dedication was evident. The bike was unveiled, offering a sneak peek of its capabilities. Dinner, a fantastic buffet, added to the experience. The beachside event with entertainment was truly unique, leaving me impressed. You got a water boy bag, you got a riding jersey, I guess, a Santa teddy bear, another CFMoto jersey, that's a nice cap, right connected by Santa, a CFMoto cap, a Santa t-shirt, a CFMoto head bar, arm socks, the media manual, you got a wristband, and sand bike spray. El Nido, Philippines. A tropical paradise known for beaches and island hopping. It's also a heaven for motorcycle enthusiasts, with incredible B roads to explore. In the morning, we gathered for a safety briefing, split into groups, and got briefed on today's route. Next, we hopped onto buggies, headed for the bike park. I am getting nervous. So we're going to start mounting all our cameras and get the bike ready. And then we'll start our test ride for the day. So this is my bike, number 31. Same as my armband number. This is the 5-inch TFT screen. Cranking it up for the first time. The exhaust sounds pretty good, man. I like it. The twin exhaust. One of the most senior journalists in this industry, correct?
That's what they say. It's hot, not so humid, but hot. A beautiful place. If you can come out here, it's great. It's very isolated. Don't bring your family because there's nothing for the kids to do here, right? Yeah. They will die of boredom.
After a mandatory group photo, our helmets paired with the intercoms that were provided by Senna and set off in a convoy with two missions. I was immediately greeted with an unpaved road. Well, I think it's a warm-up for everybody and it allowed me to get a feel of the bike. For the first mission, we arrived at the CFMoto Adventure Park where there are three levels of off-road challenges.
Oh my god, this bike feels amazing. It gave me so much more confidence than my Africa Twin itself. I cannot explain why. The throttle is responsive, the suspension setup is amazing. Open road gravel, the handling is... I don't know, it just gave me so much confidence. I'm even surprised of how I can ride.
Level 1 seemed easy, with flat terrain and gentle curves. It made me feel more confident in my riding abilities than I actually am. However, as I soon realized, there were tougher challenges ahead that would put my skills to the test.
Level 1 for me is quite nice, the level 2, damn so hard.
So just now, that was level 1, this is level 2. I'm not even sure whether I can finish level 2, but you'll see, hopefully I don't destroy that camera.
Immediately, Level 2 is tougher with longer and steeper slopes, and with tighter bends. It's starting to pose a real challenge for me to complete the route.
I'm drifting all over the place.
So this guy is our coach for the whole day today. He did a fantastic job.
If very good. If one fall, everybody helps each other.
1, 2, 3.
I always admire the brotherhood among bikers. There's a strong sense of unity and teamwork, with riders always willing to lend a hand when someone's bike drops. The encouragement we give each other fuels our collective spirit and makes this adventure even more rewarding.
I think the chances of me down is pretty high. I think I'm gonna fall the mirror.
有几个弯的中间的沙土非常松软。
我们需要去花更多的体力，更多的注意力去攻克那几个弯角。难度在于它的沙子很厚，很松软。就比如说我的入弯线路不太对的时候，我就很容易把车栽下去。Almost there, almost. 1, 2, 3.
I'm really very exhausted. So, just now, there's a perfect view here for me to rest and catch my breath. I think from here onwards, it's all the way down, going down slope. So, I have to persevere and finish this trek. Midday approaches. Together with the tropical heat, I drop the bike for the third time. Fatigue kicks in. I am too exhausted to continue.
I guess I have to disappoint you all. Never finished level 2. But it's good enough to let me have a feel of the bike. You know what? I will actually want to add this bike on my one list. I'm very surprised.
Finally, we return to familiar terrain where the winding B roads felt like home. Nothing felt amiss when riding through these twisty roads with this bike. Heading to lunch with beautiful scenery along the way was a reminder of the freedom and joy of riding.
So we take a short 5-minute break. Look at the view here in El Nido. Magnificent. Love it, man!
We enjoy a light lunch, with bikes naturally becoming the topic of conversation during our meal. If you'd like to support what we do, get our oversized t-shirt at our website, tripletree.com. Confirm nice and fashion.
I need to take a break. Oh.
I希望我可以不放弃，咱们俩就是说一起坚持到最后，一起完成这个路程，开香槟，yes.
En route to the second mission of the day, I felt much more confident on the bike, seizing every opportunity to increase speed. But would I be able to overcome the challenge that awaits me in mission 2? I did my first river crossing! What else is there that I cannot achieve?
You really should get one of these because it's a very nice bike to ride actually.
I also think so. Very nice.
Yeah. It's a very good package at a very good price.
I can say this bike is really fun, man. I might start to like off-road because of this bike. Alright, that's the end of the ride. I really enjoyed it. Hey bro, good work bro.
It wasn't an easy route, but we all completed it.
Man.
Thanks to CFMoto for ensuring our safety and hosting us this weekend. It was a well-organized event.
So El Nido in Philippines is really a very nice place to ride, especially if you have very good off-road skills. Jeremy, when launching?
May to June.
Okay, so when the bike is here in May to June, we'll definitely do a proper review back in Singapore. Ah, wait, how much?
It's going to be below 14,000 machine
below,
price.
So it's going to be below 14,000 machine price before COE and insurance. Sounds not bad, right? Anyway, it's 4:30 now. I'm fully checked out. Thank you for watching. See you on the road. Oh, I stink, man.